Hi, welcome back to The Shtick. We're in the studio with a young lady by the name of Noa Bloch.
Thanks for having me.
That's okay. What's your shtick?
So I think the reason I'm here today is I'm the National Political Affairs Director for AUJS this year.
And there's a lot of political activity in your life?
Yes. So in my role, I oversee the political activities of the Australasian Union of Jewish Students. So we represent over 9,000 students on 20 campuses throughout Australia and New Zealand. And so in my role, I oversee any kind of political activity. So that involves combating any anti-Semitism or any anti-Israel rhetoric on campus. So there's a reactive part to my role, but also there's the proactive part. So engaging with student leaders, ensuring our students are supported, knowing how to advocate effectively on campus and training them to be advocates on behalf of the community.
And all just runs on three levels. There's the national, the state, and then the campus.
That's correct. So the way that we work, so our bread and butter is the campuses. So on 20 campuses throughout Australia and New Zealand, we have our campus executives. They then feed into the state regional executives, as we call them. And then the regional executives then feed into the national executive. So I sit on the national executive, which means that on the state level and on campuses, there are also political officers. But as the national political officer, I kind of oversee what happens on a macro level politically within the organisation.
And you've got a background, actually, through your studies and working as an intern in politics.
Yes. So I've worked in politics now for 5 years. Mm. I actually, my first gig in politics actually came through AUJS. We have our annual political training seminar, which is when, it's our premier conference, I would say. Obviously, I'm a little bit biased. And it's when we take, some of our best students to Canberra and they have the opportunity to meet lots of different members of parliament and lobbyists and bureaucrats and journalists. And in my first year of university, I was lucky enough to go. And I asked a question of Josh Frydenberg, who liked my question. And then I started interning in his office afterwards. And then I was able to work for him part-time for a while. And I've then been able to go work overseas as well in the United States.
Yeah, so in Washington in 2016, you were involved working for senators in the elections.
So I was working, I was interning as a congressional intern. So I was working for a representative in the House of Representatives. And he, so he's from South Florida, his name's Mario Diaz-Balart. And so he is a Republican. He originally from Cuba, so economics and foreign policy are really important to him, and among obviously all issues.
And refugees especially.
And so he sits on budgets and appropriations committees. Yep. So I study law commerce. So I was able to have that exposure to because I study commerce, to kind of get that kind of more economic policy focus with the congressman, which was great. And I was able to then, I was there during the 2016 election, so I was able to get a bit more involved in some of the Republican races.
And what are you doing at the moment politically? Like, besides AUJS, how are you involved politically in life?
Well, so aside from AUJS, like I said, I've always been involved in the Liberal Party, or I've been involved in the Liberal Party really since the beginning of university. I've been able to work. I worked in the 2016 federal election. I'm obviously going to be out and about in November for the state election, but that's obviously all very separate to my role in AUJS. In AUJS, what I really like about AUJS is that capacity to work with people from both sides of the aisle, because, naturally I obviously am a member of the Liberal Party, which I'm proud of, but in student politics you have to be friends with everybody, and it's really important to be able to work with everybody. And what I really like about AUJS is that it gives me that opportunity to be able to work with people from across the aisle on issues that we can all find common ground on. So fighting anti-Semitism is a really good example, and I've had the privilege of being able to work with people that otherwise I wouldn't have the opportunity to work with.
And you've got an honours degree in law so far?
I will, at the end of the year, have an honours degree. I'm currently writing my honours thesis, so fingers crossed I'll get there.
And you're doing commerce at the same time, so you're doing honours... law and commerce, which will all be finished by the end of the year, both of them.
That's the plan. November. Couldn't come sooner.
I'm sure you're relieved after 5 years.
Yes, I'm very excited to... I mean, I love being a student. You get the opportunity to invest your time in organisations and causes that are really close to one's heart. And I'm hoping I'll still be able to do that when I am no longer a student. But I guess kind of being a student gives you that flexibility to do it. So, but I am looking forward to working full-time.
I must say, I think you're a very high achiever.
That's very kind.
You've done very well. You were ducks at Beth Rifka, if I can mention that to our audience, and also school captain. So I think you've got an amazing pedigree at this stage, and your father's a barrister involved with law. So I really think that you're one of the young people who we have to keep an eye on.
That's very kind.
Into the future of politics. And you've also been involved with taking students to Israel. How was that?
So AJAC runs a fantastic program called the Rambam program that I'm sure your viewers have heard of. It's where they take they take journalists and politicians to Israel to teach them about the Israel-Palestine conflict. And so for a number of years now, they've been also sending a student trip, so taking, you know, the up and coming leaders on the student level from both sides of politics. Mm-hmm. And so this year I worked with my counterparts at AUJS to send two of our leaders on that trip as well, so that they first of all could obviously learn about the conflict in it through AJAC, who are experts in that area, but also to work with these student leaders to kind of to build relationships, to understand how it is that the non-Jewish world engages with Israel, but more importantly to be able to continue the discussion when they get back to Australia.
Because I saw you last week at the launch of the Victorian Liberal Friends of Israel.
Yes.
Where there was a very large 300 people turned up at the central synagogue.
Mm-hmm.
And we were privileged to have speeches by Josh Frydenberg.
Yeah.
And also Matthew Guy. Yes. Guy Matthews, I always
Matthew guess. Guy, the leader of the opposition.
Him. And also David Sharma, who is also a high achiever. He was, when he was introduced, we found out that he got 100% in his VCE. Remember
yes.
that bit? I
yes.
was just like, wow. And he was the ambassador, the Australian ambassador to Israel.
Have you seen his video from when he was ambassador?
No.
There's a great video that he made when he left the embassy at the end of his time in Israel. You should watch it. It's a great video.
Well, he spoke very highly of Israel. He's after his experience there. He spoke very, and on the night he spoke very highly of Israel. That was a very incredible cohesion amongst all the speakers, and they all had one thing in common, and that was that the Liberal Party is a strong supporter, especially the Victorian speaking for that party, of Israel. And we're going to come back with you in the next segment, because there was another event that I saw you at, and that was when Melbourne welcomed the XMK, Isaac Herzog.
Yes.
Who is now the chairperson of...
the Jewish Agency.
That's it. And you asked a question of him, and we're going to come back with a bit of your question and also some highlights from the event at the launch.
Sure.
We'll see you then. We'll be right back after the break.